To make a reproduction of this model, we will use Matrix Neo, a polymer modified gypsum that is inexpensive, easy to use, and versatile, meaning that you can use it for a variety of applications and effects. Matrix Neo is mixed 2 parts powder to 1 part liquid by volume. Anyone who enjoys cooking on a regular basis knows that for proper mixing, it is always best to sift powders into liquids. The same method applies here, and we first pour our liquid component into the mixing container, and then slowly sift the powder into the liquid. 2 cups of powder are added to 1 cup of liquid. A drill mixer is then used to mix parts A and B. The mixture is poured into the mold cavity. As you probably observed, we did not mix enough Neo to fill the mold cavity. You could certainly mix enough material to cast this piece solid, but it would be a lot of material, and the finished casting would be very heavy, taking at least 2 people to lift it. Instead, we will employ a hand rotational casting technique that will result in a hollow casting. The theory behind rotational casting is to pour a small amount of Neo into the cavity and rotate the mold so that the material coats the inner walls. Multiple batches will be poured into the mold and rotated, with the goal being to build several layers until the casting reaches a thickness that is strong enough to handle. As the layers of material build on the inside of the mold, additional batches are mixed and added. You cannot hand rotationally cast just any material. Matrix Neo happens to have just the right viscosity and pot life that makes it ideal for rotational casting. As the material thickens, you can work it with your hands. After the final batch is cast, the material is allowed to cure for about an hour. The screwdriver is used to separate shell segments, exposing the rubber mold. The rubber mold is carefully removed from around the casting. In the end, 4 batches of Neo were used to make this casting, about a gallon unit. The casting is a perfect, lightweight reproduction of the original.